I went to a French-American football game. It was great. It was awesome, to be honest. I loved it. It was my first American football game, you know, to witness it in real life. So the two teams that you can see on the field, the first one, the red ones, there's a Pionnier de Touraine, the Pioneers, I think you say. So they're from this city, Tours. And the other team is from Rouen, which is a city in the northern France. They're the Leopards. Leopard. Oh, Leopards. Oh, Leopard. Well, first of all, because of COVID, again, like some members were not here. Some of the, like, I think three quarters of the cheerleader team was not present because of COVID. So it was not like a perfect day for everybody, but it was great. So the game was really interesting. The first thing I thought was, it's going so fast. Wow, like, it really is going so fast. You really have to be very, like, careful and watch carefully what's going on if you want to follow the game. But also, it's weird because it was going very fast and at the same time, it was so slow because, like, the real game moment, the action moments were going so fast, and then there are so many moments of nothing, like the players talking together, the time they spent to go back into their place, or the referees, I think you say, they spent so much time talking because we had like three referees from one team and three other referees from another team. So like a lot of time they weren't disagreeing, so they took so much time, like, you know, talking. Well, it has to be like this, but yeah. And I read somewhere that an actual game only lasts, like, the action is only lasts like 11 minutes for like a few hours of a game. That's pretty crazy. Thank you. So yeah, by half of the time, I don't know how you say that, la mi-temps, half of the game, I guess, the Pioneers were winning 42-12. And we had like a little dance from the cheerleaders. They're so cute, they're very young. They are very young, and yeah, 3/4 of them were not there that day, so they really did their best, they were really cute. I did not put the music on because of the copyright owners, but yeah, they're very cute. So yeah, if you didn't know, we have an American football team here in France since, I think, 1983. There are 225 clubs in France, so it's a lot. This number is from 2016, so we may have more teams right now. So unfortunately, American football is not, like, it's starting to be a little popular here in France. I mean, more than 200 clubs, it is popular, but what I want to say that, you know, on TV, there is a very, very little coverage of the championships, unfortunately. So, of course, the local press will probably do like an article or two about like a championship if it's happening or a game. I remember I saw probably 5 photographers at the game. There was 1 local TV, I think. Yeah, a woman was there. The NFL championship is covered on TV. There is a channel in France in which you can see, I think the first time was last year, they covered, I think, all the games. So it was great for people who love, you know, American football to be able to see it on French TV. Actually, the Super Bowl is coming up, and I think this is the same. We're gonna have a coverage, if you say that, on French TV again. So yeah, at the end of the game, the Pioneers won by 50-12, and it's actually their second win from the beginning of the season, so it's great. They're starting off very, very greatly, if you can say that. So overall, it was a really, really interesting game to watch. It really is like, when you witness it in real life, you learn so much than by reading stuff and all. I watch a lot of videos to understand American football, the rules and all, the rules explain, that kind of stuff, but it really is different when you can watch it in real life. But it would have been a lot better if I had someone there, it was me, who will have said, you know, like, that is called that, or what he just did is called that, or this is this and that, you know, like someone explaining to me the rules or stuff, but it's gonna happen later, I guess. Overall, it was really interesting and I loved my first French-American football game. I'm looking forward to see an American football game in America, I mean in the States. And yeah, I hope you guys liked it. I'm gonna leave a lot of links down below to the Facebook pages of those teams, the Wikipedia page of like the French-American football clubs and websites, and also if you want to check that out, you can scroll down this video. So that's it for today. Next time we're seeing each other, I will be back at Smoke Texas BBQ for part 2. I filmed some preparation. I questioned Charles with some questions that you have for him in the first video, and I tasted ribs, pulled pork, and a lot of amazing food. So see you next week for this video. Bye.